One of the single dumbest ways to kill yourself rock climbing, and this happens more often than you think, is when somebody rappels right off the end of their line. You're coming down off a nice multi-pitch climb, it's been a great day, you're just zipping down, looking at where you've come, and whoops, that rope whips right through your hand, through your belay device, you can't hang on to it with your left hand, and you just fell to your death. Or, God forbid, you're the one running the belay, and you're bringing someone else down, you're watching them, it just pulls through your hand, and off you go. So, a stopper knot in the end of your rope becomes incredibly important. So today I'm going to show you the Ashley stopper knot. It's a great knot, it's easy to tie, it's easy to remember, it doesn't use a lot of rope, and it's secure.
So this is Ashley's stopper knot. It was devised by Clifford W. Ashley sometime around 1910. He also wrote the Ashley Book of Knots, which is basically the Bible on knot tying. I'm going to show you first how to tie this in a live action sequence, and then I will show you in a picture form, step by step, how to tie this knot.
Take the tail end of your rope. First thing you'll do is you'll form a little loop where the tail wraps under the line. Take your little loop and move it over and pull the long end of your rope through your little loop. So now you've effectively created a nice slipping loop right there. With the tail end, come around and through the back of the loop you just created. Pull that loop down, pull your tail down, cinch everything down real good. It'll jam in there like that, creating the nice trefoil design. And by trefoil, I mean it's got 1, 2, 3 loops with the main line running right up through the center of that, which creates a beautifully flat-faced knot that'll jam up against your hand or your belay device in the event that you run out of rope and you hit the end of that thing. So it's a great knot. It's very strong. It'll resist pulling through an opening really well. And then when you're ready to take it out, just simply push on the long end up through. It reopens that loop. Pull out the tail, and the knot will pop itself right out.
First step is to take the tail end of your rope and form a small loop. Next, take the small loop and place it over the top of the longer end of your rope. In this next picture, I'm pointing to the section you want to draw through the loop that you've just formed, and then pull down on the short tail to cinch that knot over the long end of the rope, forming an eye in the rope. Bring your tail around the back of the eye and through the eye. Pull down on the long end of the rope to cinch your small tail into the knot, and you finish the Ashley stopper knot. In this picture, you can see the front and back sides of the finished Ashley stopper knot. Notice the really nice symmetrical flat-faced trefoil design on the long end.
Okay, so now we're back to where we started, and only this time we've got a stopper knot in the end of our rope, and we're belaying down, or rappelling down, sorry, and you get the end of that rope and you hit that knot, and oh geez, yeah, I guess I was, you know, right at the end of my rope. Or God forbid, you know, you're going fast enough and it starts to suck your hand into the belay device and you go ow, like an idiot, and let go of the rope. That Ashley stopper is big enough and flat enough that it'll jam right there into that belay device. I really like that trefoil design. It creates a nice big spot that'll hammer into your hand, so you probably won't let go. If you've got your hand down at your side, when that knot hits it, it's going to stop your belay device anyway. But, you know, the only downside would be is if you somehow got done with everything and everybody's down safe and you're about to pull your rope down and you pull out your belay device and you send your rope up, that knot's probably going to get stuck in your anchors up there. So you have to at least have the presence of mind to untie this thing before you try to send your rope back through the anchors. But frankly, I would rather deal with a stuck rope up in the anchors than accidentally belay off the end of a rope that didn't have a stopper knot in it. So anyway, I hope you learned something, and stay safe out there when you're climbing.
Thanks for watching my video. If you liked what you saw, please take a moment and click the like or thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel.